This is a tutorial on cash flows from investing activities. We are going to use this information and calculate the cash flows as a result of all these activities. We have been given data about purchases or sale of certain fixed assets. You have machinery, investment, goodwill, copyright, some details. Some additional details have also been provided. So using this, we will prepare the cash flows from investing activities in this format which we have been using. Let us read through the details to understand what is happening here. Machinery worth 240,000 has been purchased during the year, which means this is an outflow. Also, machinery worth 45,000 has been sold, which means this is an inflow. Likewise, all the sales are going to give you inflows and all the purchases are going to result in an outflow. So we can just directly take these numbers to the cash flow statement and post there. Let's look at the other information as well to just figure out what else is happening. An existing machinery was used by a research institution on a fee basis, and income of 10,000 was received. So out of the machinery that you have, you rent it out for, you know, to some external party, and they use it and they pay you some fee. You did not set up the machinery. The machinery is usually used for production and not to earn. So you don't regularly use the machinery for such incomes. So this is kind of an investing income to you, not an operating income. So 10,000 is an income, and let me write it here. This is an inflow as a result of investing activities of the business. The next point is interest on investment at the rate 10% of investments purchased during the year. So the investments which were purchased during the year is 2 lakhs, and 10% of that is going to be 20,000. This is an inflow. This is also an income during the year. This is income on the financial investments made during the year. And then a previous investment, not the ones that we purchased, but the previous investments that the company already has, also yielded a return. Yielded meaning, you know, brought to the business, earned actually. So this is also an inflow which needs to be shown. So that's it. We have identified the inflows and outflows. So all we need to do is to post these amounts in the statement. So we have, let's put the inflows first. So machinery and investment 45,000, 120,000. 45,000, 120,000. And these are machinery and the investment here. Then you have inflow from rent usage, 10,000. Interest and dividend received. We do not have any item here listed at fee. So fee for use of fixed asset, right? So this comes out to be 10,000. So this is done. Then you have interest on investment, 20,000, and interest, another interest of 10,000. So total 30,000. I'm going to write against this number, 30,000 against this line. Then you have outflows. Outflows include four outflows, 240 and 2 lakhs, 240,000, and you have 2 lakhs, 50,000 and 20,000. 50,000 and 20,000, and we just need to write the details. Machinery investment, this is machinery, this is investment, this is goodwill, and this is copyrights. So you have a purchase of fixed asset and purchase of investments, and actually, you know, intangibles as well. So all three items are covered in here. There you go. And all these are outflows, so I'm going to put parentheses around all these numbers. So all we have to do now is to sum these up. This comes out to be 440, 490 and 510. On the other side, we have 130, 160, 205. So 205 taken from 510 is a 205. So this is 205. 305, actually. 305 is the net cash from, no, this is a negative number because 510 was the outflow. So net cash used in investing activities is 305,000. That's how you prepare the cash flows from investing activities. I'll see you in the next video.